Storage is the fastest growing segment in IT, and that has to do with the volumes of data that we were just talking about. And the demands that we set on storage have changed. Storage used to be this box there, this server where I have my data and that I access my data on. Now storage tends to be more decentralized. I have storage in a lot of different places that I want to be able to address as if it was one single storage box, and that requires me to have the data much more faster. I cannot accept delays anymore. It has to be much faster. It has also to be always available. And at some point you find that the technology of hard disks is not any more suited for the demands of the future. And that is, for a long time, people were still working with hard disks because there was also a price difference. But more and more, the prices of hard disk storage and of SSD tend to grow towards each other. And you really see that the market is moving towards SSD, that I see a lot of new installations of data centers that forego hard disk entirely and that go fully on SSD to meet these demands of reliability and of speed that are nowadays indispensable.
What are the key advantages of NVMe SSDs over their SATA counterparts for data center applications?
Well, as we were talking about, the demand is for more high density computing, is for storage that can be accessed remotely in a number of places with very low latency. And so, of course, NVMe has a much higher throughput, has a higher speed, is more performing. And you really see a trend that because of the demand, because of the requirements that people are putting on it, NVMe is gaining market share. Mind you, this doesn't mean that SATA is an inferior product. It's still, for many applications, it's still absolutely fine, and it will remain absolutely fine for quite a while also. Here is also, as I would say, for people who are considering their investment now, the question that you have to ask yourself is what do I need? What do I want to do? What are my applications designed for? What is the latency that I can accept? What is the speed that I need? What is the density that I need? And you may find that indeed in the more modern applications, especially when you're moving towards things that like AI that require high speed, NVMe is the choice for which you go. But don't discard SATA yet.
How do you see the role of SATA SSDs evolving in data centers?
I think there is still a future for SATA. I think we're far from done with it. I think also certainly a lot of the machine learning applications that are right now is a fast growing segment. They run also on earlier versions of CPUs. They don't run on the latest CPUs. They don't need to run on the latest CPUs. And they are actually quite comfortable working with SATA memory. And I believe that what we're going to see in 2025 is a twofold movement. On the one hand, we're going to see migration towards NVMe for a lot of the newer applications that customers demand that have these very high requirements, but we're also going to see still a growth of demand for SATA in all the machine learning applications that require very robust infrastructure, but that do not have as the top priority the very low latency and the super high speed of NVMe.
What are some of the potential challenges in transitioning from SATA to NVMe in existing data center environments?
I think the main thing that you need to look at here is what is your application? What are the requirements of your application? How does your application work with your storage? How does it work with your server? What kind of compute does your code require? What kind of demands are you putting on the whole infrastructure? Because there is not one simple answer, and for every case will be a little bit different. And these are questions that you have us to accept that at some point we'll get quite technical, and that most users will probably not be able to entirely solve on their own. And this is maybe a good moment to also get some expert help to assist you with that. And I would say Kingston asks an expert, and that's a very good place to address your questions.